Given the equation of the parabola, we want to find all of the characteristics listed here below. To do this, we're going to write the equation in this form here, and then by determining the value of h, a, and k, we can determine all the information that we need. So the given equation is already in this form, but I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this as the quantity x minus 3 squared. And on the right side, I'm going to write 2 times the quantity y minus 0. Notice how the right side of the equation is still 2y, but now it fits the form perfectly. Now the first thing we should notice is that the x part of the equation is being squared, and therefore the parabola will have a vertical axis, or vertical axis of symmetry, which means the parabola will open up or down based upon the sine of a. So we know we have a vertical axis. So now let's find the value of a so we can determine if it opens up or down. Looking back at the form of the equation, we know 4a must equal 2. So if we divide both sides by 4, we can see that a is equal to 2/4 or positive 1/2, or if we want 0.5. So because this value is positive or greater than 0, we know the parabola will open up. So let's start by finding the vertex of the parabola, which will have coordinates hk. Because we have the quantity x minus 3, that means h is positive 3, or the x-coordinate is positive 3. And because we have the quantity y minus 0, we know the y-coordinate is 0. Let's go ahead and plot the vertex on the coordinate plane. That would be this point here. And we'll go ahead and sketch a rough parabola now that opens up, because this will help us find the additional information. We know our parabola is going to look something like this. The reason this helps is now we know the focus must be above the vertex or inside the parabola, and the directrix would be below the vertex. And the distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the absolute value of a, and the distance from the vertex to the directrix is also equal to the absolute value of a. Well, since a is positive 1/2, the absolute value of 1/2 is still 1/2. So we know that the focus must be 1/2 of a unit above the vertex, or this point here. This would be the focus, this would be the vertex. So in order to find the coordinates of the focus, we would add 1/2 to the y-coordinate of the vertex. So the focus would have an x-coordinate of 3 and a y-coordinate of 1/2. And then to find the equation of the directrix, it would have to pass through a point 1/2 of a unit below the vertex, or this point here. But the directrix would be this line here, which we can tell would have the equation y equals negative 1/2. If we wanted to, we could subtract 1/2 from the y-coordinate of the vertex. Notice 0 minus 1/2 is negative 1/2, which would give us our equation. And then for the equation of the axis, or axis of symmetry, and from here we can find the equation of the axis. The axis would be a vertical line passing through the vertex and the focus, or this line here, which would have the equation x equals h, where h is the x-coordinate of the vertex, so we have the equation x equals 3, which we can also see from the graph. And now for the last step, we'll find the endpoints of the latus rectum, also called the focal diameter, which, looking at our notes, would be this green segment here. Notice the latus rectum is parallel to the directrix. It passes through the focus and has both endpoints on the parabola. And the length of the latus rectum is equal to the absolute value of 4a. So notice for our equation, 4a is equal to 2, which means the focal diameter, or latus rectum, has a length of 2 units. So let's go ahead and clear the rough sketch of the parabola and find the endpoints of the latus rectum. So from the focus, we'll go 1 unit to the right and 1 unit to the left of the focus. Notice how this segment would have a length of 2 units. It passes through the focus and it's parallel to the directrix. Notice the endpoint on the left would have coordinates 2, 1/2, And the endpoint on the right would have coordinates 4, 1 half. Another way to find these coordinates would be to add and subtract one unit from the x-coordinate of the focus. Here's our focus. Notice that 3 minus 1 would give us 2, giving us the point 2, 1 half. And then 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, so we'd have the other endpoint 4, 1 half. But now because we have 3 points on the parabola, we can make a more accurate sketch of the parabola, which would look like this. Of course, we could find more points on the graph by making a table of values, but as you can see, just by analyzing the equation, we've found a lot of specific information about this parabola. I hope this was helpful.